Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Compete League Open League. My name is Chase Pathology Patterson. I'm joined by Jesper Benvarmeren Kunz. Ben, so how about game two?
Well, I like game two. It was more different than game one, and Eliminated actually showed up in this game. Again, they had a bit of a pick composition, not 100% pick composition, but they were able to make it work. And by God, did Terrakio just snowball that game out of control.
Yeah, definitely. I would be surprised if we didn't see an Aurelia ban or a pick come out of Dynamic Dudes. They do have the first pick in this draft. But I mean, there's just so little chance in my mind that either team is going to let that pick come through again. And also, I want to point out the sneaky switcheroo, the role swap there between Terrakio and Onions, showing that Eliminated have threats from multiple sides.
They definitely do have threats from multiple sides, and now it looks like Terrakio is back in the middle lane, but he can definitely go to the top lane if needed, like in the last game, but this game he will be in the mid lanes. But as you said, Irelia might be the first pick coming out from Dynamic Dudes at this point. You either have to pick it or you have to ban it, because while Terrakio is not in the top lane, it is still a very strong pick, and Onions might be able to play that as well.
Yeah, interesting also to point out that we're seeing a bit of a roster swap here. Dynamic Dudes bringing out Shingu as well as Schattenklinge. Shingu is going to be playing there in the top lane, whereas Schattenklinge is going to be playing in the mid lane for them there. The other positions, jungle, AD carry, and support will be filled in just as before. Ruffy in the jungle, Molly in the AD carry position, and Killeridge in the support position.
Yes, and now it looks like everybody is in the LCS order, so we might be getting into the game very soon, but I'm looking forward to seeing what Shingu and Schattenklinge can bring to the table, because we haven't seen them play in the series before. So going up against Terrakio and Onions, they don't know how they are going to be playing, they don't know their playstyle, and they might be caught out of surprise.
Yeah, it could be indeed, and they're also very smart of Dynamic Dudes to pull them out now, as opposed to perhaps a little bit later in the draft. Definitely, like, you know, trying to go for a little bit of a different style, perhaps, moving away from the picks that they brought in earlier. Although we have to say, like, Kroxa did really well on the Victor in that first game, boosted by the early kills. So props to him. He just wasn't really able to repeat that success in the second game, mostly due to the Karma pick, though, coming out of Eliminated.
That is true, and if Kroxa can't play anything else than Victor, then I feel like it probably is the best idea to bring out someone new. And against Terrakio, again, he doesn't know how Schattenklinge plays. So that is definitely an advantage already going over to Dynamic Dudes, both mentally and in-game in terms of mechanics.
Yeah, and I mean, I think it's going to... these new roster swaps here coming in for Dynamic Dudes could also change their pick and ban phase completely. I mean, they might decide to prioritize different picks that they were banning away before. I mean, could we even see Talia come through this time around? I mean, who knows?
Maybe.
I think it'll be really interesting to see.
Yeah, that might be something that could go through this time. Something I hope not goes through for Phantom of Justice is that Ashe pick, because while it wasn't the one that snowballed very heavily, you don't want to give them up that Ashe that can be so huge. So Ashe, off the table please, or you pick it for Dynamic Dudes. And now, while we are in the pick and ban phase, I'd like to see Eliminated go for kind of the same composition as in the last game, where, yes, you had to pick potential, but you also have teamfight potential. You can do this again.
And we're seeing the respect ban. So Talia being banned away immediately, Terrakio kind of known for that pick, and the respect ban sort of coming out of Eliminated, making sure that Aurelia is off the board for future games.
I wouldn't call it a respect ban. It's more just Onions and Terrakio saying, we don't want to pick up Irelia, and we don't want to give them Irelia either, so just ban it away. We don't want to risk them picking it up, so ban it away.
And now, actually, interestingly enough, Dynamic dudes banning away their own Braum pick, and Vladimir now being banned away as well for from Eliminated. So, the two staple bans for this so far have been both Taliyah and Vladimir, interestingly enough.
I do agree with banning out Braum. If you don't want to pick him up and you don't want to go up against Morgana, if you want to pick Braum, you have to ban out Morgana. That was what I wanted to say. You don't pick Braum into Morgana anymore. Money for Fun has found a way to counter Braum, and it has shown to not work. So at this point, Braum is not the right solution you're looking for.
Yeah, definitely going to be interesting to see whether or not Killer Witch picks up some other different champion inside his vast pool. Perhaps the Blitzcrank, the pocket pick, could be Boop. You never know.
I wouldn't mind.
And we're seeing the final bans being Swain on the side of Dynamic and the Dynamic dudes, and Illaoi being banned away by Eliminated. And now a cozy Morgana hover coming out of Xingu. Could he be taking it away for Money for Fun? Could he be making that bold move early on in the game?
Yes, please do it. I mean, Money for Fun has just played this champion in the two games we have already had in this best of five series. Take it away, force Money for Fun onto something else and see how it does. You still have at least three games to play through, so if Killer H can play it, just pick it up. But then again, we have to remember, it can't be a flex pick. He can go to the mid lane. He can even go to the top lane if needed.
I'd be really interested to see what the top lane Morgana could do, actually. That would be really fun to see. As we're now seeing, wow, a quick lock-in, both Nami and Dart and Olaf being picked up. I'm gonna venture a guess that Darkridge is gonna be taking that Olaf into the the jungle, though.
Most
Nami,
likely, yes.
however, probably going over to Money for Fun.
Most likely Darkwitch is going into the jungle with that Olaf, and I feel like that is an answer to if Ashe is going to be picked out, then now you already know that there is going to be someone that will be diving you. And Nami is a standard pickup against Morgana, because if you put a few points into ebb and flow, you can just break away the Morgana shield really fast. So it's time to pick up against Morgana.
Yeah, and now we're seeing the quick lock-ins between Ruffy going back onto that Rek'Sai and Schattenklinge picking up a trusty Fizz.
So it's too early to say that they have the pick potential coming, the pick composition coming out from the side of Dynamic Dude, Dynamic Dudes, sorry, but Fizz is also flex pick, as he can go to both the top lane and the mid lane. But he definitely brings with Chum the Water some more pick potential, especially now that Rek'Sai and Morgana is also coming out. But we have to wait and see to what are coming into the last two picks from Dynamic Dudes.
Ice in the veins of Eliminated as they just stare down into the eyes of Dynamic Dudes and say, "We don't mind picking up Anivia. This could be a totally worthwhile pick for us." And they lock that in for Terrakio, as well as Phantom of Justice picking up his MF from the earlier game as well.
Okay, so Terrakio goes for Anivia, and I actually kind of like that, because now when you know Fizz could potentially be a mid laner, Anivia will be able to shove him in, and she's also a fairly safe mid lane as well with her Ek passive. Fizz will have a hard time killing her, and Misfortune coming out, Phantom of Justice played that in the first game of this best of five series, but had a pretty lackluster showing.
Interestingly enough, we're seeing a Caitlyn hover here out of Molly, could be going for that pick again. Worked very well in the first game for him. And Killer Witch hovering the Karma. So we're seeing a lot of straight flexing, if I do say so myself, coming out of Dynamic Dudes right now. Unless Killer Witch swaps at the last minute. No, it looks like it will be that Karma pick, potentially heading over into the mid lane, I'd say.
Yeah, this means that Karma is heading to the mid lane, Morgana is going to bottom lane, and Fizz into the top lane. And
Oh, the Quinn lock-in.
yes, so Onions, Quinn is his third most played champion in ranked. And I don't mind this, because now you are against Fizz and you're going to be able to punish Fizz a lot with your Q, which brings I can't remember, does it silence your attacks anymore? I think it does. So that is going to be strong against Fizz. but also your auto attack range against Fizz, you will be able to poke him a lot, and he fits really well into this. Again, it is kind of a pick composition, but also a teamfight composition that Eliminated has gone for. And again, you don't need to fix what's not broken. So I like the composition that Eliminated has gone for.
Yeah, a great, very interesting composition indeed. It looks like, however, no, Killer Witch is going to be keeping that Karma in the bot lane, unless, no, and Shadow Kling is going to be taking Morgana into the mid lane. This is very interesting indeed. We're just waiting for the game to load in here with that 3 minute timer there. But this is okay. So I think I have two questions in this situation. First of all, what does Morgana, you know, how does this lane play out between Morgana and Anivia? And supplementary question to all of that is it possible that Onions is taking this Quinn, although Quinn does have a lot of mobility and has the freedom to roam with using her ultimate, like down into the mid lane and stuff. Is it possible that Onions is swapping, role swapping yet again to go into the mid lane using that Quinn?
I don't, that is a hard question, because then they wouldn't be in the right order, in the right pick order. So we're going to have to see that in 2 minutes, but regarding Morgana and Anivia, that lane is just going to be a farm lane basically, because Anivia just wants to keep shoving the waves, and so will Morgana want to do with her pool. So basically they're just going to be farming up, but I while I like Karma going into the mid lane, Morgana is kind of the same. You have crowd control, you have damage as well, and both can really roam really well. So now I'm going to be watching that mid lane really closely, because Morgana, she is a hit or miss, and Karma, if she had a bad laning phase, she would have been more reliable in my opinion, but we'll wait and see, because it's not really about the laning phase for dynamic dudes. It's more about getting out of laning phase, hitting that mid game power spike with Caitlyn reaching a Rune and Hurricane and Infinity Edge, and then you can start to protect her because you have so much peeling for her, and then you have the backline threat with the Fizz.
Yeah, going to be very interesting indeed to see whether or not dynamic dudes, can sort of flex their pick potential here. And then we saw how in the last game Karma can do so much work when she's played as a carry. It could be really interesting to see how this, you know, sort of changes the speed boosts, perhaps to get Morgana better centered onto the team using her own ultimate with the chains. And I think I'm really glad that we're seeing a Fizz come out at the same time as we're seeing picks like Quinn. I mean, we're seeing a whole lot of new picks out of both of these sides right now, especially in the Fizz, and on the Eliminated side even more so with the Quinn and the Olaf. So let's talk jungle real quick, like while we're loading into game here. Yet again, Darkridge on this Olaf, what are his early game objectives here going up against Ruffy on that Rek'Sai?
It is to help his bottom lane, because Misfortune and Nami is a strong lane, and while Karma and Caitlyn also have the advantage, I feel like in the 2v2, because you have the poke and the range advantage, Olaf can go in there, and if a bubble will be landed by the support from Eliminated, then Olaf will have a fairly easy time coming in there and at least forcing a flash to be blown. So for Olaf, it's all about snowballing that bottom lane, or at least keeping them safe.
Right, we'll see if Olaf and Darkridge can make that happen for his team. As we are just loading into game here, folks, you are watching Compete League Open League Europe finals between Dynamic Dudes and Eliminated. Dynamic Dudes playing on the blue side with Xingu on top lane, Ruffy in the jungle, Shouten Klinga in the mid lane, Molly in the AD carry position, and Killeridge in the bot lane as support.
And for Eliminated, they have Onions in the top lane on a Quinn. They have Darkridge playing Olaf. They have Blackfrost and Anivia coming out from Terrakio, Captain Fortune being played by Phantom of Justice, And Money for Fun is once again on Nami, and well, Money for Fun likes to play the slippery fishes.
Slippery indeed. We'll see the battle of the fish there between Shingu and Money for Fun. We'll see if they can get up to any good. Perhaps we'll be seeing a couple of early birds in Terrakio and Onions trying to get the worm in the form of Ruffy's Rek'Sai. But
Quinn is a bird. She has a bird. You know what bird eats fishes?
Oh,
yeah,
that's true. They do. I mean, so this is, so what you're saying is that right now dynamic dudes are the prey and they have to watch out for birds up ahead, for what might be coming for them.
Exactly.
So,
jokes aside, I'm really looking forward to seeing what Shingo is going to be building, because here in patch 6.12, Wit's End, its cost has been reduced, Trinity Force has been reworked, Berserker Greaves has been buffed as well, now gives 35% attack speed instead of 30. So basically, a lot of these bruiser items could come out from Shingu and could allow him to take over the games if he wants to go for the more bruiser-like builds.
Gonna be interesting to see whether or not he can pull that off, and especially, let's talk about this Fizz versus Quinn lane real quick. Who comes out ahead in that matchup?
That is going to be Onions. Unless something really weird happens, it is going to be Onions, because she has the range advantage, she has more damage, and well, soon enough, she's not going to have a blue buff, but she's just going to have more damage than Shingu. But then, once you reach the mid game, which is the power spike that dynamic dudes are looking for, then I'd rather have a Fizz just from the waters and the damage that can come out of Shingu.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what happens here in the Killer Ridge and Money for Fun trading blows a little bit. This early game is brought to you by Anivia versus Morgana, the Season 1, Season 2 traditional mid lane. Molly and Killer Ridge doing a little bit of work there, pushing Money for Fun and Phantom Justice off of their CS as Shingu is forced to hop and skip and jump away to make sure he doesn't get hit by those augmented auto attacks there. Onions, like you said, definitely has a bit of an advantage over Shingu, at least so far in this early game. We're seeing already a significant CS discrepancy, all things considered, 8-3 so far.
And again, it is just because Onions has a bigger auto attack range and can just poke and punish Shingu so much more for going up and trying to pick up CS. So Onions is naturally just a prey to Shingu.
Yeah, do we see Terrakio though getting hit by the Dark Binding and eating a lot of damage? Not faring quite, having a bit of trouble there early on. So we're now seeing Morgana Schattenklinge hitting another binding into the Tormented Soil. Terrakio, and perhaps in a bit of trouble there, is already forced to chug one of his potions. He's gonna try to keep up, but he's already falling a little bit behind, almost double CS going over to Schattenklinge right now, as we now see Shingu also struggling though in the top lane up against this Quinn.
But Ruffy is there, and Ruffy's doing the right thing. Oh, Onions!
Oh, Onions overextends a little bit. He's gonna eat so many tower hits, and he's gonna be taken down by Ruffy with help from Shingu, and only an ignite popped on both sides, but that's the first blood going over to Ruffy, actually. And Shingu's gonna be all the happier. He's gonna get a bit of a reprieve from his lane.
Really smart played by Ruffy. He knew that he has to help Shingu, because Shingu is having trouble in top lane. If you don't help him, he's going to have a hard time, and then Onions will just be able to do what Terrakio did in the last game, take over and snowball this game out of control.
Yeah, and we see Killeridge and Molly trying to get really flex their advantage there in the bot lane, but every time that they hit up the Eliminated's bot lane, it looks like Money for Fun has the perfect bubble to answer and try to make sure that they don't get that their trades don't go completely unevenly.
But well, as I said, in the bottom lane, it is Molly and Killer Exit has the advantage because they have more poke and they have a bigger auto attack range. So naturally they will be stronger, and you can see that because a Phantom of Justice, he's falling behind some CS, but here comes Darkridge.
Oh, Darkridge forced out of his hiding spot there, forced to pop the ghost as well to make sure he doesn't get hit by the binding. And unfortunately, a bit of a wasted opportunity. Really well spotted out though by Shotgun Kling. A really good map movement to make sure that he can prevent the gank from happening.
And I love what Dynamic Dudes are doing already, because they have drafted some strong lanes, or Ruffy will just get blocked. Oh,
Ruffy not though, he goes around. In the meantime, Shotgun Kling hits the Dark Binding, so he's able to get a bit of damage onto Torikyo. And it looks like he's gonna have to back away a little bit there, as his lane is actually pushing towards closer to the middle, so he has to watch out to make sure he doesn't get taken down. And Shingu, that smart early investment in both both cloth armor and a ruby crystal means that he can withstand more attacks from Shingu, actually.
That is true, and he also has his corruption potion to just bring him more sustain. But as I was saying before Ruffy went to the mid lane, I love what Dynamic Dudes are doing, because they drafted some strong lanes in the bottom lane, and then in the mid lane they just drafted something that can stand their own against Torikyo. So they just have a lot of ability to pressure the map, and Molly will flash in to try and get a kill onto Phantom of Justice, but doesn't have quite enough damage.
Yeah, and we're seeing this bot lane, Phantom of Justice being kind of greedy, almost like falling very close to he's only a couple of hits away there, but he's trying to do his best to stay even in CS. They're only falling to 10 CS right now, but Onions, the early flash, sees the tunnel coming in from Ruffy, gets a little bit of damage back onto Shingu, and he's gonna saunter away, happily.
Well, it was worth the try, but Onions knew that Ruffy was there because of that ward. And now I love what Ruffy is doing, because he knows that he has to help his top laner. You don't need to go to the mid lane. Shotgun Kling is holding his own. Bottom lane is holding their own. So just try and help Shingu. Try to let him get more CS, relieve some pressure, and get a few items as well.
Yeah, impressively enough, Shingu's only about 15 CS behind right now, which works out really well for him. As we see Darkridge now taking his own blue buff, going over to the Gromp, and try and get a little bit more tanky before he tries to go in for another gank, perhaps. Or he could be trying to set something up here in the bottom lane, as we see the first Drake of the game spawn. It's going to be an Infernal Drake, and could be hotly contested.
And it should be highly contested, because in my opinion, Infernal Drakes are probably the best dragon out there, just because it gives you the raw stats, whereas a Mountain Drake, you need to be able to snowball to use the stats that comes out from the Mountain Drake. So I feel like an Infernal Drake is definitely something you want, and with someone like Shingo being a hybrid, you definitely want to. Oh, but Molly and
Phantom is very, very forward, eats a lot of damage now. Rek'Sai is here as well. Ruffy will see what he can do. Can he get the knockup? Money for Fun gets knocked up. Indeed, he's forced to flash away. And now Ruffy eats a bubble. He's not going to be able to pursue. But Torikyo, the egg is popped. Shotgun Kling is forced to flash away, and Darkridge is right on him. Shingu lands the Chung the Waters, but not any more damage is going to be able to go onto Onions. Now, Shotgun Kling manages to dodge the axe, but will go down to the auto attack in the end. The rage coming in really handy there for Darkridge.
Well, Darkridge getting a kill onto Shotgun Kling helps Torikyo with relieving some of the pressure and actually pushing that wave in, so that Shotgun Kling will lose some CS, and Shotgun Kling doesn't even have his teleport up, so really smart for him to get that kill, and it just helps Torikyo so much.
Indeed it does, and I mean, so far this game is going a little bit more evenly than it was previously. No Aurelia means that, and more even lanes means that this could be a bit of a longer game, unless one of them can start to run away with it. So we see just about even in each lane, with only a slight favors in the mid and bottom lanes going over to Dynamic Dudes. Those fresh picks coming in pretty handy for them.
And we have to be wary now of the build that Phantom of Justice is going for. Oh, wait, actually, Onions.
Oh, Onions waiting for Shaman Klinger to come around. Shaman Klinger eats an auto attack, an empowered one at that, plus the blind, and looks like he's going to have to back off a little bit. Everyone's going to have to be a little bit more prudent there around the Rift Herald.
Has to be careful around the Rift Herald, indeed. You don't want to give that buff over to Onions. But as I was saying, we have to be wary of the build that Phantom of Justice is going for, because like in the first game where he played Misfortune, his first item were a Beer Sword, and that went into a Duskblade of Draktar. So with Phantom of Justice also being behind, that the mid game might be hurt by him not getting so much damage.
Phantom of Justice is taking so much damage, and Money for Fun is forced to use the wave in order to clear away both Killerich and Molly. Now Darkridge answering in the top lane. Ruffy and Shingu couldn't be in a bit of trouble, but now Darkridge is gonna get minion blocked and is gonna be take one or two tower hits before backing away.
Killer H might find
Money for Fun in a bit
fun.
Of trouble though. He could get popped. That's a first bubble going, taking, stopping Molly, but last pilt over Peacemaker will take him down in the end. Now the second kill of the game going over to the side of Dynamic Dudes.
But again, the mid game power spike has been delayed so much from Phantom of Justice because he has been falling behind in CS. He's not been able to finish his item quite yet, and his support also just gave up a kill. So basically, Molly will be better in the next 10 minutes just because she's getting more more items. So now Schattenklinge in the mid lane.
Yeah, Schattenklinge doing a little bit of damage there to Terrakio. Terrakio, very little mana, and is forced to back away. Darkridge is coming in just for a little extra pressure. He's going to throw an axe, field goal, and say, no, not in my mid lane. Onions, though, keeping his CS advantage. Oh no, not keeping his CS advantage. The Charm of the Waters is going to miss just barely, which means that Shingu is not going to be able to get any extra damage off on him to him. Although Darkridge now in the blue side, near the red buff, Schattenklinge taking a very low dark. The shield is not going to protect him from auto attacks, but he just barely survives thanks to a shield from Killerage. And now Darkridge is forced to run away thanks to a little extra speed boost there from Money for Fun. So close to getting that kill, but that Karma Shield coming in crucially right on time. Phantom of Justice, though, in a bit of trouble, does not have Flash available. Could pop the heal to try and stay alive a little bit longer. He'll be going down to Molly. Oh boy. Bit of an overextension there.
I'm not convinced by Phantom of Justice's misfortune because it's going wrong again. He's not able to bring out the level of play you have to bring out on a misfortune in the grand final. It is going wrong. His Duskblade of Draktar is so delayed. He's giving up one kill. His support is giving up a kill as well. And Molly is just so much stronger. And now Money for Fun might even be dived to bring Molly even further ahead of Phantom of Justice.
Yeah, Molly definitely making that Caitlyn pick work for him once again. Now 2-0 and 107 CS. Money for Fun, though, in a ton of trouble. Forced to pop his own ult. Molly will be taking it down. Third kill going over. And he stays alive despite being under turret.
But they're getting dove in the bottom lane.
Yeah, Terrakio coming in. Caw, caw, caw. No, that's not a Fiddlesticks. What am I talking about? Money for Fun. Molly taking down in the end. Killerage, though, does so much damage. Shiku coming in with a teleport as well. Turn the water for the Terrakio. Terrakio does not have his passive available, I believe. The egg, will it be pumped? Yes, he does. He just does. But Ruffy will be in there as well. He'll be taking him down with the help of Shingu in the end. Even before the egg is popped, Phantom of Justice in so much trouble. Schattenklinge taking him down as well. And that is, I believe, a 2-3 in favor of Dynamic Dudes. Now 2k goal ahead.
Such a good response coming up from the Dynamic Dudes. They knew that they had the teleport advantage. Onions would not be able to respond to the bottom lane. And Shingu is... or was in a good spot when he joined the bottom lane because he had a Sheen and he had a Barmy's Cinder. So he was just in such a good spot. Schattenklinge were in a good spot as well. They had a lot of damage also coming up with his items. That is nearly a Sonia's hourglass being completed. And all of that was without a Molly, the one who is really fed on the team. She wasn't there, she was dead.
Yeah, great moves there by both by the entire team, making sure that but they get the kills back, and in that two for four is going to make sure that they secure the first dragon, the drake of the game, which I believe was an infernal drake, if I'm not wrong. Yes, it was.
Now, okay, so we can see the Dark Witch is coming into the top end. Shingo just used his jump. Oh.
Yeah, Shingo and Onions. Though Shingo is able to get the chum, the water is going to get a little extra damage onto Onions. The poison plus the minions are going to take him down. Shingo, does he have the flip available? He will not be able to flip away. Dark Witch will take him down in a one for one with an assist going over to Quinn. But Onions not performing as strongly on his top lane champions as he's been in the previous games. Phantom of Justice now locked up by the Karma. He's taken down so low, pops the ultimate, but oh, Molly flashes over, and he's going to be taking down. That's a double kill going over to Dynamic Dude's bot lane. Great flash there from Molly to avoid the ultimate from Misfortune, but it looks like Torekio is going to try so much damage. Karma flashes forward, very daring move. Torekio is locked up. He's going to try and do a little extra damage. It's not going to happen, though. He's looking, but he can only find minions. It looks like he'll be backing away, or the bottom lane there for Dynamic Dudes will be backing away.
And it looks like it's going to be a repetition of the first game for Phantom of Justice, where he's simply not going to be relevant. He doesn't even have his dustplate. Oh, Onions in the bottom lane.
That's quick takedown.
Oh, but here comes Rek'Sai.
Rek'Sai could try to find Onions. Will he make it happen? The Shotgunning him. Finds a Dark Ridge. Finds a Viking in his jungle. But here comes Onions. He could be onto Shotgunning in a lot of trouble now. Ruffy is there, going to try to help out. Dark Ridge could be going down. Yes, he will. Ruffy will take him out. As Money for Fun tries to come in for the backup, and now he's in a lot of trouble. Gets popped up by the Rek'Sai, and looks like he'll be going down thanks to another extra Dark Binding and the Tormented Soil from Shotgunning. As that turns very sour for Eliminated very quickly.
Very sour indeed, and Dynamic Dudes, they're getting the kills onto the right targets. They're getting it onto Molly. They've gotten it onto Shingo as well, who is going to be the split push monster. He has a gauntlet now, so he's going to be strong in a 1v1. He could even go for a Wit's End to be stronger, Yumu's. Blades of the Ruined King, there's a lot of options open for him because he is allowed to do so because he has so much farm, so many kills, and the pressure he will bring with items will be immensely, but Shotgunning might go down here.
No, Shotgunning in a bit of a tussle there for Torekio. Well, Torekio flashes forward, but Ruffy's here as well. Shotgunning, all you have to do is stay away. He does, the chum of the water is gonna stall Torekio. But he will be taking down Shotgunning in the end. The egg will not be enough, though. Ruffy and Shingo will take him down. Darkridge coming in towards the end, but too late. Not fast enough. You run, Viking, as he's going to have to satisfy with himself with a few minions and watching his bird die.
Shingo is too strong at this moment. If you can't go up against him in a 2v1 with Olaf and Quinn, then nobody can heal him. And, well, here comes the 2v1.
Now Shingo is going to try to skip and jump away. He does not have anything available, though, once again, but Quinn can follow him over. Onions looking for his revenge kill. Shingo tries to dash, but no, he will not be able to avoid the auto attacks from Onions. Too good, too strong. Onions now sitting at 124 CS and 2-2-1. Trying to come back into this game, trying to keep Shingo at bay.
And now, with the mid game being reached, I'd like to see Dynamic Dudes push their limits, because Onions has to deal with Shingo in the top lane, so you could group up and start to utilize Molly. He hasn't... Okay, so he's not maxing his traps, which I feel like is a mistake. Oh, actually, here comes Onions.
Onions with a daring move, but the wave comes in. Will not hit anyone. Killridge, safe and sound. Molly, though, manages to dodge the ultimate from Phantom of Justice. Phantom of Justice and Money for Fun caught. Double kill goes over to Molly as Torekio now caught up in the Chum of the Waters. Huge damage, does not have the egg. Even with the tower there, it does not look like he might survive. The poison might do it. But no, he manages to stun Shingo. Shingo, the dash on top of...
Oh, he survived! No!
Onions does not survive. Just barely. Very close.
Shingu, however, made it through. The ultimate from Caitlyn going in just in time, and the tower going down as well. And now Dynamic Dude sitting 10 kills ahead and 4k gold ahead of Elimited.
Well, this was not exactly what I was thinking about when I said that they could push their limits, but they found a fight, they found the picks, and they were able to get a lot of them. So now they have a 4,000 gold lead, and the mid game is so strong right now for them, because Caitlyn has just reached her 2 item power spike. You have 2 items on the side of Shamkling as well, and Shingu has 2 items as well. Oh, Ruffy will be able to get away, but the second Infernal Drake has just respawned, and I don't think that Dynamic Juice can contest this, as Eliminated are already onto it, and Ruffy is very low.
Yeah, they're not going to be risking that unless Molly, nope, no steel going over, but Onions dashes over the wall. Ruffy is in hot pursuit, but he cannot contest. Onions is very, very strong right now. Molly does manage to secure that red buff.
But as I was saying, there is a
huge this is in such trouble. Shankling takes it down in no time flat. Spell immune to Rikio. Money for Fun cannot do any damage. He's on his front of the tower. He could be sacrificing his life. The bubble will secure him down. But very, very cool kill coming in there from Shankling.
Well, very cool, and a kill that doesn't bring anything good to you, because you just gave up a bounty to the enemy team, so it wasn't worth it in the end. But as you said, it looked cool, and sometimes it's about sending a message instead of actually doing something something good. But now, again, they have a good mid game on the side of Dynamic Dudes, and they could really use this really well, because if they just send Caitlyn into the mid lane, she doesn't have her traps maxed as her second ability, but you can still put her there because she will be able to take down towers very fast. And then you can just let Shingo do his thing in the top lane, and Karma and Morgana will be able to protect Caitlyn no matter what. So just start your group up and protect Caitlyn and take down towers, but here comes Onion!
Kill Ridge in a bit of trouble, forced to flash away. Onion's doing a lot of damage, and Money for Fun popping his ultimate, trying to catch someone out. Well, not in the end. Dark Ridge, though, is right onto Molly, forcing his flash away. No CC can be applied to Dark Ridge. Molly's in so much trouble right now. He's forced to use the net to go over the wall. Carriage almost dying to Phantom Justice as ultimate. And now Onions, he dives in. He gets the kill onto Molly, but he'll be taken down by Shingu in the end with the Chunder Waters is used. Now Dark Ridge is doing so much damage to Ruffy. Ruffy taken down so low, but Phantom Justice goes for the auto attack onto the turret instead. And Shankling are getting a kill in the mid lane onto Nami, taking down Dark Ridge as well. Huge opportunity there for Eliminated, but it turns out Dynamic Dudes just have the moves.
And this is what happens when you get Molly. You use so many summoners, you use so many ultimates as well. A lot of resources just generally being spent onto killing Molly. And, well, Shingu, you forgot about him. He's just going to be able to kill your team without any problems, because he is so strong. Top lane fizz is not something you want to forget about. And, well, if not him, then Schattenklinge in cooperation with Shingu is just going to be winning team fights all around for Dynamic Dudes.
I think it's also important to point out that Ruffy has been there exactly when his team needs it to be at every turn. In the gank that we see, like, rarely is Ruffy not there when his team needs a CC and his tankiness.
Yeah, that is definitely true. Ruffy hasn't been there all the time, but he has a huge kill contribution, so he has been there a lot of the times. But again, now just group up. I mean, you have such a huge power spike at this point, so you could just group up. And now Money for Fun is about to go down as Ruffy comes in from the side.
It looks like Money for Fun is forced to use his flash to get away, as he was getting caught out there by Killeridge. And right now you have to be wondering, what can Eliminated do to come back into this game? Because they have the team comp. They have plenty of abilities at their disposal, plenty of resources at their disposal to make a comeback, but how do they make it happen?
Well, despite them being behind, I don't feel like they are out of control. Oh, never mind, Phantom Justice is dead.
Shingu whiffs the Chum the Waters very closely, but nothing Phantom Justice can do on that immobile MF in order to get away from the deadly power of the deep, as he gets taken down by Killer Ridge and Shingu.
Okay, so to answer your question, you have to rely on onions to create some pressure on the top side. And even then, I don't feel like, despite you being behind 6,000 gold, that you are without any. Oh, wait, actually, we're going to see 5 and top.
I think there's a lot of trouble. There's a teleport coming in for Shotgun coming out from Shingu as well. Ruffy's going to be taking down onions in the end. Onion for Fun uses the ultimate in order to get a little bit of CC down, as Darkridge will be taking down Ruffy for the first time in the game. Shingu, though, in a bit of trouble. Terrakio comes up from the mid lane, but Shingu is able to dodge. But no, Terrakio goes down in the end. The egg will be popped, although he will be taken down by Molly, although Darkridge now onto Killeridge as well. And finally, taking down Triple Kill goes over to Schattenklinger.
And Phantom of Justice were not there, so like in the last game, Phantom of Justice is just so non-existent on this pick and generally brings nothing to the team. But this just means again that yes, while the rest of your team is actually, they are fairly well into this game, what are Phantom of Justice doing?
What? You have to ask yourself that question right now as he gets taken down under his tier 2 top lane turret. Onions now and Money for Fun both there as well. Schattenklinger manages to dodge the bubble though, but well times Onions.
Well, teleport coming in from Terrakio, and now they want to chase onto Dynamic Dudes, but is that very wise? They might find a kill onto Schattenklinger at least.
Oh, that's a huge amount of damage coming out of Terrakio, but no! Oh my god, he gets taken down by the binding plus the torrented soil. He almost took down Schattenklinger, but Schattenklinger is just too good on that Morgana. And too far ahead, it's sitting at 10-3-6 on top of that.
Exactly, it is just the name of the game, Dynamic Dudes. They are very far ahead, and the problem for Eliminate is that they have no AD carry, basically. Yes, your top laner were actually doing pretty fine, all things considered. Your mid laner were also doing pretty fine, but your AD carry is non-existent. You don't have an AD carry in this game because she brings no damage to the team, basically. And you need to get her into this game if you want to come back, but Phantom of Justice is about to die again!
He was on tilt. Shingu takes him down, that's his 9th death of the game. Phantom of Justice having a very hard time with this MF here.
Definitely having a very, very hard game, and well, Dynamic Dudes, there's really not much they could do at this point. Yes, you could start to group around Baron, but we are only 27 minutes into the game. You could start to push up waves in the mid lane and top lane. That would actually be the best idea for them now, because there is still inner turrets there, and Shingo is soon to have his teleport up, so You could start to do that, and now Onions
caught out as well. Schattenklinger is not able to take him down, but Onions is forced to use his flash. No summoners available for him in the next fight, and the next fight could very well be happening at Baron.
That combo is so brutal. Onions took so much damage then, and he even has a Morph Memortius, so it's not like he doesn't have any magic resistance.
Indeed he doesn't, and we see now Dynamic Dudes looking to set up this Baron. They are about 19 kills ahead, but they still aren't putting the pressure down quite as much as they could be. Relying on picks, they're trying to get ahead, but the longer that they wait out this game, the longer that they can't necessarily rely. I mean, although Phantom of Justice goes down once again, frontline MF, not necessarily the hottest pick of the day. But the longer that Phantom of Justice, Dynamic Dudes wait out and try to go for, you know, for the pick, and more picks, the longer that they put themselves at risk of falling into the trap where the late game is going to be the late game, and, you know, one or two kills can decide the entire game.
But for that to happen, Phantom of Justice needs at least 20 minutes to even be a little bit relevant. But here comes the fight, and Jingo is teleporting in.
Yeah, Killeridge taking a lot of damage, but now Onions is on the backside. He's taking a lot of damage. Shingu keeping him very far away from anywhere where he can be relevant. Darkridge now in a ton of trouble. Caitlyn ultimate is coming out. Managed to take him down, almost down all the way. Now Ruffy being taken down. Shingu in a bit of trouble. Gets bubbled up by Nami, but he'll take a shield from Karma and move away. And now Dynamic Dudes get to punch onto the mid lane once more.
Oh, Shingu? Ah, well, he gets away. So now finally Dynamic Dudes are pressing their advantages. They get a tower and there's no inner turrets left in this game. Now all that's left for them to do is to crack open the base. And I feel like Baron is the right answer here because there's simply not enough crowd control and AoE damage coming from the side of Eliminate, that they can stop a Baron. So for now, Dynamic Dudes just go in there, ward up, buy a lot of pink wards, and then you could Baron dance. And something I hate to see at this point in the game is that when you are this far ahead, Shuttenklinge should not have a Doran's Blade. He should have a pink ward instead.
Well, I mean, a Doran's Ring, you mean? I think you said blade. And I was confused, and I was looking at the 80 carries. I was like, "Where's the Doran's blade?" Anyways, I mean, I'm still surprised to see that Dynamic Dudes are maybe perhaps a little bit scared of taking this Baron. I mean, they have so much damage. Even although Dark Ridge is very tanky, he could try to waltz in and try to take the Baron. But I mean, Ruffy now onto Onions. There's a Caitlyn ultimate coming for her as well, taken down to about half health, and it doesn't look very good for Onions right now.
Yeah, they're going to be finding again, and why not? You can find the pace, just go for it.
If it ain't broken, don't fix it, and Dark Ridge forced to pop his ultimate in order to escape that Morgana binding. And it looks like we could have a siege on our hands here.
But as you said, it's very weird that Dynamic Dudes are this scared of going for the Baron. Now they're finally going for it, and they have the Mountain Drake, so they have 10% true damage to that. They can just tear it down really fast, especially with all the damage that Molly can come up with. Look at it, it's dead.
No time at all for Eliminated to come back and try to take that Baron, and they know it just went down. And now all they have to do is wait and brace themselves for the onslaught of Dynamic Dudes.
Now they have to defend their base. And it all relies on Terrakio, because Phantom of Justice doesn't pack any damage, still doesn't pack any damage. He needs at least 15 minutes more to get an item or two. So Terrakio is the only one that can really do anything at this point. And it is against Baron up minions, so it is looking rather hard for Eliminated, but at least they got a Band of Command. But Onions, you're dead, man.
Oh, Onions is in so much trouble. The Chum of the Waters comes out. That's going to be tons of extra damage onto him. The Hex Drinker gets popped, but Onions just has no chance up against the Slippery Fish right about now. And, I mean, as much as he might try to be doing some Slip Push, there's very little he can do.
Exactly, and Shingu is also raining on my parade, because I've been talking all game about how Trinity Force got buffed, Wit's End is now cost less, and the Circle Creeps has also been buffed, and he gets neither of them, so I would have loved to see this Split Push dual monster, but he's itemizing for teamfights, and well, that is smart, I have to give him that, because he is a huge annoyance in teamfights, and Molly just got caught out.
Oh, Phantom of Justice with the ultimate. Tons of damage though coming in. I believe that was just stuff from a Tormented Soil, and looks like Dark Ridge could be going down as well. They're in hot pursuit there. Dynamic Dudes will be taking down Molly, getting his ninth kill of the game. Shuttenklinge now casually hitting the turret as one does, tanking up for his team, waiting for those Baron up minions to arrive, and it looks like we'll be seeing the first inhibitor of the game go down at 35 minutes, or 33 minutes rather.
It could even be the game here. Terrakio cannot deal with Baron up minions. Phantom of Justice is non-existent, and Onions will go down really fast as well.
Killer Ridge, Master Distraction, Karma comes for you, and Onions will be taken down by Shingu once more. No, it looks like Caitlyn actually. Molly getting the kill. Shingu, though, keeping everyone away, and it looks like Molly goes down, but there's nothing that Eliminated can do to stop these empowered minions, and the 50 gold will be going over to Shingu, who gets the last hit on to the Nexus, and that's game three going over to the Dynamic Dudes.
That is indeed game three going over to the Dynamic Dudes, and well, the two games that Dynamic Dudes has won has been where Phantom of Justice has been playing Misfortune, so I think we might have found at least one of the problems, because when you play that Misfortune as Phantom of Justice, you're simply non-existent, sorry, not existing, and you have no damage. And actually, the rest of your team did fairly okay, considering the circumstances. So perhaps something like Ezreal, just generally another AD carry would be better.
Now, I think that the first thing, like you said, the first thing that Eliminated will need to move away from, I think, is that MF pick. It's just not been working out for them. I don't know if they need to do a lane swap. I don't know what they need to do in order to make that pick work. But so far, out of two games where they've played it, it just hasn't been working. At this point, I'd count that as a loss. I don't know about you. And the other thing that I think we need to point out is just the massive amounts of damage that Morgana brought out this game. More than I believe anyone else in the game, dealt 33k damage. The closest person to that on both teams was Molly's Caitlyn at 25, at almost 26k. So an amazing pick there coming out for Schott and Klinga.
Yeah, Schalke definitely showed how to play a mid lane Morgana, and I wouldn't mind seeing that again, because that team composition, that dynamic you just went for, it worked so well, because you had the late game insurance in Molly. Molly were ahead, even if she was just even with the Phantom of Justice, she would still be really good because you had so much peeling for her, and now you have to look at taking away Fizz in the next game, because I feel like Fizz is the biggest problem that Eliminated couldn't deal with. You can deal with Karma, Morgana, and Caitlyn, but you couldn't deal with Fizz.
Indeed, we'll see if the Fizz pick comes out again, and I certainly hope that, like you said, I mean, not to touch on it too much, but that MF pick, I'd be interested to see whether or not maybe Molly wants to pick up the MF if he thinks it's worth it, and well, we'll just see whether or not they make it happen.
Exactly, but we are going to be jumping over to a break, so we'll be right back. Go grab some popcorns, grab some cola or Mirinda, whatever you like to drink, because this is getting so excited. We're going to game four, and we have a series on the hand, and maybe a series that is going to be ending in the next game. So we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.